Hi everybody, this is Jennifer with Choice Slides, and in this tutorial I'd like to take just a few minutes to clarify some things that I had mentioned back in this spider tutorial about motion easing. I said a few things that a few people have gotten confused about, and I want to clarify those. So if you are coming from ProShow, motion easing works exactly the same way it did in ProShow, but in Photopia, you just happen to have a lot more choices. Photopia Director, anyway. Again, and if you're using Creator, the only motion easing you have is on position. If you're using Director, you have it on zoom, rotation, tilt. Now, if you're coming from ProShow, you may remember that motion easing only worked on effect attributes such as, you know, position, zoom, rotation. In Photopia, they have upped their game, and you can now have motion easing on color adjustments and things like that. I'll show you how that would work, since obviously motion easing even has the word motion in it, but the concept is still the same. So in this tutorial, I mentioned that you could only add motion easing to the first keyframe. I need to clarify that. Not the first keyframe in the whole timeline, the first keyframe of two keyframes. And I didn't add it to this one because the second and third keyframe are the same, so there was no point. So for example, in this useless slide I've made here, I have four keyframes. And every single keyframe is different. In this first keyframe, it's up here. Second one, it's down here. Third one, it's up here. And between the second and third, by the way, I've changed the brightness, so I can show you how that works. And then the fourth one is in the bottom. So there's motion between every keyframe. I could add a different motion easing to every keyframe. So motion easing basically tells the program what to do as it comes out of the keyframe you're adding the motion easing on, and then into the next one, which is why you can't have motion easing on the last keyframe, because there's nothing going out of or into. So motion easing tells the program how to go out of this keyframe and into this one. I could have a different motion easing on this keyframe, telling it how to come out of this keyframe and into this one. And again, with ProShow, you only had these four, and these really are the basic four you'll mostly only need. And in my previous tutorial, I told you maybe don't worry about these, because these are kind of crazy and the wording is really insane. As with a lot of things that I mentioned, I'm going to go ahead and backtrack on that. You could actually use a lot of these four images. Just be super careful, because some of these add a ton of motion. Let me just show you an example. So in this slide, I have three keyframes. This image sits still from 1 to 2. Then from 2 to 3, the zoom goes from 85 to 0. So it's going to sit still, then it's going to shrink away. But I have added a back in motion easing to the keyframe when it goes from 100 to 0. And if you remember from the spider tutorial, the lower left side of this image is your first keyframe, and the upper right side is the second keyframe. So zoom wise, what's going to happen is it's sitting still, then it's actually going to zoom up a little bit, then go down to 0. That's, again, these wordings are not great. Watch the image. So it's going to kind of bump up in scale, then go back. So let me show you what this looks like. From keyframe 1 to 2, it just sits there. Then from 2 to 3, do you see? It came forward and came back. That wasn't done with keyframing. It was done with motion easing on that second keyframe, because that second keyframe is the first of the two where that motion happens. So in that previous tutorial, when I said the motion easing goes on the first keyframe, it's the first keyframe of the two that has motion. If I were to add motion easing to this third keyframe, nothing would happen, because there's no keyframe after it. But motion easing doesn't go backwards, it only goes forward. So that's what I meant by the first keyframe. Now let me jump back and show you a little bit about how motion easing might work with color adjustments. So in this case, I have the brightness on the second keyframe going from 0 to negative 75, right? So it, with no motion easing whatsoever, and the second keyframe, it's fully bright, and then it just ever so slowly goes down to negative 75, and that's what normally would happen with a linear setting. Now let me add kind of a crazy motion easing, and again, I would want to set it on the second keyframe, not the third. So right now I'm sitting on the third keyframe, which is where it's all the way down, and that's not where I need to be. Remember, you need to be on the first of the two keyframes where your animation is changing. So on the second keyframe, I'm going to choose a super crazy motion easing just to show you what this looks like. We're going to do elastic out and in for the brightness and watch what happens. So in that case, it almost got like a flickering effect, right? Which that could be pretty cool too. So that's why I was saying, ignore what I said before about don't using all those other ones, but remember what I said before about the names being a little bit crazy. Watch the graph if you really want to see what is going to happen first keyframe, second keyframe, and those will get, you know, they'll take a little bit of time to get used to, but once you get used to using those, they're actually pretty stinking cool. Just don't make your images fly all over the place, please, pretty please. So that's motion easing in a nutshell. It's how your image changes from one keyframe to another. You cannot add it to the very last keyframe for that reason, because there is no other after that to change it to. And Photopia has added the ability to add motion easing to color adjustments, which is pretty stinking cool. And outline and shadow, all of these can be kind of given more control in between two keyframes. And they've given you a gazillion new ones, not labeled great, but the visuals will definitely help you figure out what you need to do. And that is a basic overview of what motion easing is. Thank you so much for watching and for allowing me to help you unleash your creativity.